I'm Niall Hunt. I'm the digital content lead at TV Connect, and I'm here with Carter Pilcher of Shorts TV. Carter, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Niall. Lovely to be here.
So, Shorts TV, tell me a little bit about it.
Well, Shorts TV has been around a while. We're the first channel to ever take short films and make them into a cable channel. We did that in 2008 and launched it in Europe. And in 2011, we launched it on DirecTV in the United States. So we're in about 35 million homes currently, and we're just about to launch into another more than 35 million homes, both in India and a Spanish language version of the channel in Latin America. But Shorts TV, so Shorts TV is all about people who love movies and really love movies and are into short movies primarily. But in the movie industry, I'm the only astronautical engineer in the Academy of Motion Pictures. And in the movie industry, shorts are not just a genre, but they're where everybody who's any good practices and tries things out because it's cheap. So they if you're going to try out a new type of making a feature film, if you're Alejandro Iñárritu, who made Birdman, he did a series of three shorts before he did Birdman, just trying out different ways of filming characters and action scenes and different effects that he wanted to look at. He wrote them into stories, he tried them, and all of that happened before Birdman. So shorts is also, in movies, it's really where new stuff is really being discovered.
It's exciting content, but I mean, it has its own particular challenges, you know, in the OTT world. Can you tell me about that?
Well, shorts really does have its own challenges. One of the big challenges is that nobody has ever heard of a short film that they know the title of. We, of course, all know any number of movies, the titles, Star Wars, Pretty Woman, all of those instant images, because we've been so heavily marketed to, maybe we've seen the movie. Even if we haven't seen it, we know what it is. Shorts, there are no shorts. No shorts that anyone has ever seen that they really remember even the title. And so getting our viewers to be able to select a title is very, very, very difficult. They just don't know what they're gonna see when the title comes up.
So what's the approach?
So we took a lot of young, smart folks and worked with our audience. We've tried a number of different solutions. None of them really worked. Until we said, some of our guys who listen to way more music than they should, said, you know, this is a lot more like a movie service like a music service than it is a movie service. It's not like Netflix. You can't look at all these beautiful pictures and know what you're going to see. So we have created an app that is an addition to the channel. We call it Big TV. So you get the channel, the app, and a mobile app that's coming out soon. And the app actually allows you to access the content based on your likes, your skips, or you don't access content that you skip, but you get the more you like them, the more content it feeds you. It's very similar to Pandora or Spotify's algorithm that just feeds you content or feeds you songs the more you listen to them. And just like those same algorithms, we never let the film stop playing. So you never choose. You just watch.
It sounds a lot like kind of having your iPod on shuffle. I mean, is it that kind of experience that you're talking about?
It's exactly that kind of experience. It's a much more focused experience than just a random shuffle. It's a shuffle that has your own preferences, so that it keeps introducing new films to you that are more like the ones you like. We launched the service with about 2,500 films, almost 1,000 hours of content. Shorts, just shorts, nothing else. So there is an enormous amount of film just to explore. And we're finding with our viewers that they have opportunities they never imagined, and they get to see films that are related to films that they've liked in ways that they probably didn't expect. So we're getting a lot of positive comments.
So you're a set-top box app now, but you're launching on mobile when? This weekend?
Well, no, we're starting testing with Apple The iOS version of the app comes out in the next week or so, and it starts testing by the end of the month.
Sounds fantastic. Carter, thank you very much for spending time with us. One last question. Have you enjoyed TV Connect?
It's great. It's a great group of folks. It's a very, very interesting environment, and it's amazing to be able to talk to both technology and software developers, as well as other channels. It's a great mix of those two, all of those put together.
Brilliant. Carter, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much, Neil. Lovely to be here.